In this example, I'm going to show you how to apply a pre-created style. This style is for the roads, and what it's going to do is it's going to colorize them and provide the width for the different roads, and it's also going to label the roads. This style comes from OpenStreetMap. It was created by an organization that makes the OpenStreetMap files very accessible. It's a German company, and in a few weeks I'll show you where you can download these files from. So the first thing you're going to do is, your road file might look a little different, but the first thing you're going to do is just hit properties, and then you're going to go down to the bottom left and you're going to hit load style. So these files are QML files, and they can be actually edited in a text document. So, you know, I encourage you to take a look at it at some point. And if you get good at these things, you don't necessarily have to edit them in the software. You can actually edit some of the code. So in this example, we're going to hit the button there, and we're going to use a style that I already created for you, or I already have for you, and it's in your Lake GeoData folder. It's in a folder called Styles, and it's this GIS OSM Roads Free 1 QML file. We're going to hit Open. You're going to hit Load Style, and you're going to notice that for both symbology and labels, it's created this rule-based labeling system, right? So these are custom symbols and custom labels, as opposed to what we normally do, which is we make everything the same, right? When we're working in ArcGIS and when we took our fundamentals class, right? Whenever a lot of maps that we created, we just simply categorize them or put them in quintiles, but we use something called single symbols, basically. So in rule-based, it's a little bit different, where you set up the rules of how things look and how things are labeled. So let me show you quickly, for labels, I do want to point out something, that many of them are scale-dependent, right? So the motorways will show up from a minimum scale of 1 all the way up to 500, what is that, 5 million. And the one that we're going to edit in a couple of minutes is these secondary roads. So your map has to be below 35,000 in order for below 1 to 35,000 in order for it to show up. So right now these secondary roads will not show up when I show you the map. So we're going to hit apply, hit OK, and then just give it a second to load. And while it's doing that, notice my scale down here is 1 to 40,000. So there's our road layers. So if we wanted to turn on some of these secondary roads, like this road leading up to this hiking trail, what we could do is go back to properties, and we're going to take our secondary road, and we're going to change this value so that it's above this 40,000 scale that we're currently at. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to change this to 41,000, and then I'm going to hit OK. I'm going to hit apply, hit OK again, and just give it a second to load. And notice that we have this additional secondary road that's labeled. And that's, again, it didn't show up previously because it's scale dependent. Thanks.